Take a sip of ocean water and you'll taste why most land animals can't drink it. It's far too salty. And yet, we know that life on Earth began in the ocean. Many animals still live there, but the rest of us make our homes where we have access to fresh water. And some animals spend their whole life in and around lakes, ponds, and rivers. These are the animals of the freshwater biome. It turns out, moving from salty to fresh water was a bit like moving to another planet. Animals needed to develop new ways to live in this different environment. Today, even though fresh water makes up only 3% of Earth's water, you'll find an amazing variety of animals live there. Each one, from beavers with their waterproof fur to fish with special cells that control salt levels, has its own solution for freshwater living. Let's look at how these animals solved the challenges of their watery world. We're glad you're watching Socratica Kids. You know us for our smart, fun videos, but did you know there's more to the Socratica Foundation website? You'll find courses, worksheets, games, and even educational souvenirs for your home or classroom. Visit Socratica.org to hashtag learn more. In the world of rodents, size matters. Adult beavers tip the scales at 71 pounds or 32 kilograms, making them the second largest rodent in the world. Their size and strength makes it possible for beavers to accomplish some impressive feats of engineering that smaller rodents couldn't dream of. Beavers are known for building dams out of wood and mud. These dams then create ponds where beavers build their homes, called lodges, complete with secret underwater entrances. This ability to build dams is one way beavers are well suited to life in the freshwater biome, staying safe from predators and other potential harm. So, how do they do it? One essential tool are a beaver's teeth. They use them to cut down trees and gather materials for their dams and lodges. In fact, beaver teeth never stop growing. What if our teeth did that? Imagine how that would affect you as you got older and older. The beaver has other physical adaptations that help them with their job once they get in the water. Their webbed feet and flat, paddle-shaped tails make them excellent swimmers. The phrase busy beaver exists for a reason. By building dams, beavers create wetlands that shelter countless other species. This role earns them a special title, keystone species. A keystone species is an animal that an ecosystem is heavily reliant on. In the case of the American beaver, their dam building activities create wetlands that support many other plants and animals. But there can be more than just one keystone species in an ecosystem. Another keystone species in the freshwater biome is the river otter. The river otter is a playful and energetic mammal found in lakes, rivers, and marshes across North America. River otters can be found sliding down riverbanks and gliding through freshwater, and are especially good at this because of their long bodies, short legs, and webbed feet. River otters are carnivores and eat fish, crayfish, frogs, and small mammals. Otters have thick, waterproof fur that keeps them warm in the cold water. You know that feeling of getting water in your ears and up your nose? What if it was possible to avoid that? River otters can close their ears and nostrils while diving to prevent water from entering. What a useful adaptation! River otters are social and live in family groups where they spend a lot of time playing, grooming, and hunting together. While it's true that river otters can survive on both land and water, they prefer to spend most of their time in the water. Here's another freshwater resident who can survive both in water and on land, the common loon. The common loon is a bird that lives on lakes and ponds in North America. During the breeding season, loons build their nests right near the water's edge. This can be on small islands or floating vegetation. But loons don't just live right next to the water. They spend a lot of their time actually in the water. Loons are known for their rather impressive diving skills. They can dive depths of up to 200 feet or 60 meters. That's similar length to an airplane. They can dive this deep because of their solid bones, which make them less buoyant than most birds, and allow them to dive more easily without popping right back up to the surface. Another helpful adaptation is how loons have webbed feet placed far back on their bodies, which make them great swimmers but awkward on land. So, what are the loons diving for? They mainly eat fish, but they'll also eat crustaceans and aquatic insects. Even if you don't see the loons in action, you'll still know that they're out there because of their eerie yodeling calls, which they use to communicate with each other across long distances. Each sound serves a purpose. They can alert others of danger, find relatives across long distances, and more. While loons announce their presence, other animals in the freshwater biome work silently. The freshwater mussel may seem small and unassuming, but it has an important job to do in maintaining the health of freshwater ecosystems. Freshwater mussels live in rivers, lakes, and streams, where they help filter and clean the water by removing particles and algae. Freshwater mussels are often called ecosystem engineers because they improve water quality and provide habitat for other organisms. In just one day, a small mussel can filter 15 gallons or 57 liters of water. Mussels have a hard, two-part shell and live buried in the sediment at the bottom of the water. They feed by filtering tiny organisms like plankton from the water. The life cycle of mussels is unique, and in the animal kingdom, survival demands creativity. Mussel larvae catch a ride upstream on fish gills, like tiny underwater hitchhikers. Then they finally settle down and grow into adults. Freshwater mussels also play a role in North American cultural history. They used to be harvested by Native Americans and were not only eaten, but also used as jewelry. Unfortunately, many species of freshwater mussels are endangered due to pollution and habitat destruction. It just goes to show, even the quietest, smallest animals can send us a clear message about taking care of our environment. One freshwater biome species that does not have any current causes for concern when it comes to conservation is the bullfrog. The bullfrog is the largest frog in North America, about 8 inches or 20 centimeters long, and weighing up to 3 pounds or 1.3 kilograms. They're commonly found in ponds, lakes, and marshes, croaking away with their deep, resonant calls, which can be heard over long distances during the breeding season. Bullfrogs are carnivorous and have a mixed diet that includes insects, small fish, other frogs, and even small birds or mammals. They have strong legs and webbed feet that make them powerful swimmers, and their large, sensitive eyes allow them to spot prey easily. The life cycle of all frogs is closely tied to the water. That's where they lay their eggs. When baby bullfrogs hatch from eggs as tadpoles, they live entirely in the water, breathing through gills. They look and act a lot like fish, but remember, it's just a stage they're going through. The tadpoles continue to undergo a metamorphosis as they grow into adults, developing little legs and even little lungs. The adult bullfrog is capable of living both in and out of the water. Animals who undergo this process are called amphibians. This comes from two Greek words, amphi, meaning both, and bios, meaning life. They have both a land life and a water life. Whether on land or in the water, bullfrogs are hard to miss due to their size. But there's another animal who's hard to miss because of their colors. The painted turtle is a brightly colored reptile who gets their name from the vibrant red, yellow, and orange markings on their shells, legs, and heads. While it may look like it, an artist did not paint on all those beautiful colors. Painted turtles are omnivores and will eat aquatic plants, insects, fish, and small amphibians. One common place you might find painted turtles is basking in the sun on logs or rocks, warming their bodies in the sunlight. This is because, unlike us, they don't keep themselves warm. They need the heat of the sun. At some point, though, it just gets too cold out for that to work. So, during the winter, these turtles hibernate by burrowing into the mud at the bottom of ponds or lakes, where they slow down their metabolism and survive in cold temperatures with little oxygen. As with most turtle species, painted turtle males are smaller than females. Scientists think it's because of how many eggs female turtles need to produce to keep the species going. They need quite a few because the painted turtles and their eggs are food for many animals, including foxes, otters, and raccoons. Turtles are too slow to outrun their predators, so instead, they make their escape by slipping back into the water or famously hiding inside their shells. Keeping watch at the water's edge is the great blue heron. This is one of the largest and most easy to spot birds in the freshwater biome. Easy for us to spot, that is. You can find them standing almost perfectly still on the banks of lakes, rivers, or marshes as they wait for unknowing fish to swim by and catch them for their next meal. These tall, graceful birds have long legs and a sharp, spear-like beak that they use to catch fish, frogs, and other small animals. Painted turtles, too. Great blue herons are talented hunters, striking quickly with their beaks to snatch prey from the water. They are also strong flyers, with wingspans that can reach up to 6.5 feet, or 2 meters. That's longer than a tall human. Herons build large nests in trees near water where they raise their chicks. While these birds are solitary hunters, they may nest in colonies, sharing the same trees with other herons. What do you think so far? Could you see yourself living in the freshwater biome with the busy American beaver and the haunting calls of the loon? We do have a video all about this biome as part of our biome series, so you can see exactly what it would be like to call this place home. You see, when we say biome, we don't just mean the environment or the animals, but everything. Who lives there? What's the climate like? The whole experience. We'll link to that series below. Swift and silent, the northern pike is a large, predatory fish found in freshwater lakes and rivers across North America, Europe, and Asia. These fish can grow over 4 feet, or 1.2 meters long, and weigh up to 60 pounds, or 27 kilograms. For a freshwater fish, that's huge. Young pikes grow especially fast, but this growth rate slows as they get older. With their long, torpedo-shaped bodies and sharp teeth, northern pikes are made for speed and hunting. They are ambush predators. This means they will hide among aquatic plants and wait for smaller fish, frogs, and even ducklings to swim by before striking with lightning speed. They have backwards-pointing teeth, so when prey gets caught, they rarely escape. Does the surface of the northern pike body remind you of anything? Maybe algae? Or the ocean floor? Pike have excellent camouflage, with greenish bodies covered in light spots that help them blend into their surroundings. We saw how the painted turtle had to hide to survive, but imagine if they were much, much bigger. We don't have to just imagine. Meet the alligator snapping turtle. No, it's not an alligator. It just has a spiky shell that makes it look like an alligator. This reptile is one of the largest freshwater turtles in the world and can weigh over 200 pounds or 91 kilograms. These turtles are native to rivers, lakes, and swamps in the southeastern United States. Alligator snapping turtles are another ambush predator. They spend a lot of time lying motionless on the bottom of rivers or lakes with their mouths wide open. Part of their tongue resembles a worm, and they use it to lure fish into their mouths. When a fish swims too close, the turtle snaps its powerful jaw shut. After eating, these turtles can last up to 50 days between meals. That's like not eating a single meal for a month and a half. While the alligator snapping turtle can remain motionless for a long time, there's another smaller freshwater animal you can easily spot zipping around the sky. Dragonflies have long, slender bodies and large, transparent wings. And those wings? They are no joke. Dragonflies are capable of hovering, flying backwards, and changing direction mid-flight, which is something many other winged creatures either cannot do or must do much more slowly. Each wing is capable of independent movement, which allows the dragonfly to quickly fly in any direction. They use their speed and agility to catch other flying insects like mosquitoes, flies, and other small bugs. These insects are such good hunters that scientists believe they successfully catch their prey 95% of the time. That's one of the highest success rates in all of the animal kingdom. Dragonfly larvae, called nymphs, live underwater for several years before emerging as adults. Nymphs may look small, but they're mighty. Nymphs are fierce predators and eat small aquatic animals like insects, tadpoles, and even small fish. Once they transform into adults, dragonflies spend the rest of their lives in the air, hunting and mating near freshwater. Although freshwater is only a small percent of the planet's water, it supports a whole bunch of wildlife. Thousands of different animals. We only met a few today. Each animal in this biome, whether it's the industrious beaver or the agile dragonfly, has specific adaptations to survive in and around water. They all do things we can't do, that's for sure. Next time you're near a lake, river, or even a pond, look around and see what kinds of special creatures you can find. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.